Hello, I'm Stix Hooper, a wannabe musician.
Hi, this is Vincent Gardner, I'm the Artistic Director of Jazz Houston.
All right, and you guys are here today to honor the late Mr. Joe Sample. Did you all want to talk about being back in Houston and the ways that you're honoring your band member?
Well, I am really thrilled, honored, and it's very, very special to come back and pay tribute and honor Joe Sample, who a personal friend of mine, musician, we've exchanged great moments together, and I'm just happy to be here in the city that I was born and just to pay attention to that in the memorial.
And you were born in Houston. Could you talk a little bit about your upbringing and the neighborhood that you grew up in?
I was born in Houston and went to school here in the public school system, studied at Phyllis Wheatley High School, and was under the direction of one of the best musicians and band directors that I've ever known in my entire career, Mr. Samuel Harris. And he taught me how to play and taught us all, and including Joe and another famous Houstonian, Hubert Laws, and all of us.
And other than the concert, what are some other ways that y'all are coming together to help honor Mr. Joe Sample?
We want to expand the educational factor, you know, to let the generation know and let people know what jazz is about and how much Joe contributed, and I hope what I contributed and the other members of the Crusaders, that we eventually became the Crusaders. But that's what we're here to do, to expand and people to get their vision to know what's going on about America's only musical art form that's started here.
And Mr. Vincent Gardner, you're working with the Jazz Fest. How does that incorporate, how do you incorporate Mr. Joe Sample's work and legacy into that festival or that event?
Well, you know, the thing that you always hear when you listen to Joe Sample's music or you hear them listen to the music of Stix Hooper or the Crusaders is that it always feels right. And that's the thing that we always want to take and bring that as a template for everything that we do. We want our concerts to feel right, and we want the way that we speak and greet people to feel a certain way. And that comes directly from the music. And when you're playing, and you know, when you're playing in a band, as Mr. Hooper knows, it comes directly from that pocket that starts with the drums.
Yeah.
And so if it feels right at the bass, it's going to feel right all up the tree. And so that's the thing that we're always going for. We want to make sure that it feels like jazz music when we're playing.
And speaking about feelings, Mr. Hooper, how does it feel to be a part of such a legendary group?
Well, it's really wonderful to think back, because I aspired to get there, and if I can be pretentious, I knew we were good and we were going to get there. But it really feels good to be a group that has been accepted around the world, from Rome, Tokyo, we've been everywhere, you name it, the Philippines, you know, and it's just been wonderful that music has spoken for us and that we were part of creating that.
Yeah. And Houston is definitely showing love to the group. Recently, it's been announced that you're going to be receiving a proclamation from Houston's Mayor Whitmire on May 30th, or say yesterday.
Today.
Today.
This evening.
Yeah, this evening. So, Stix Hooper Day. How does it feel to have a day dedicated to you, Mr. Hooper?
Well, I could never express that in one sentence. It just feels an honor that I was able to achieve that. I know that I have my daughter here. She's observing. And also, my mom would be very, very proud, because I know when I first started, when she gave me some pots and pans to tinkle on, and to try to get myself together to play, I never thought that I would get back here in this city that I was born many, many years later and be honored on that level with the mayor, et cetera.
Yes. Mr. Gardner, did you want to make any comments on the proclamation and how well-deserved it is?
I just think it's definitely well-deserved, and I would just say that it was a great choice from the Whitmire administration to honor Stix when he's here. And, you know, we need to honor our heroes. We need to honor those that have made an impact, you know, and brought the name of Houston worldwide and made an impact like he did and like other members of the band did.
And Stix, what do you want your legacy to be as we move forward? And what is the future looking like for jazz music?
Well, I hope it's definitely moving forward, because it needs to get serious, and I say serious, serious respect in our country, because it's more respected and honored around the world. for whatever reason, whatever those reasons are. But I want jazz to move forward because it is such a great music, and it's a music that requires great craftsmanship, great creativity, and I want people to be aware of that and appreciate music itself and the audio art which it is.
And I know y'all have a really busy day ahead of you. Again, I want to thank y'all for stopping by CW39 and dropping by our Digital Dive. Is there anything that you'd like to say before you leave today?
Education.
Well, all I can say is good to be here, good to be related to all of this, what's happening in this great city that I've seen progress so well since I haven't been here in quite a while.
And I also like to mention before we go is that as part of our efforts, we're doing an education concert at Phyllis Wheatley High School tomorrow morning, and which is of course Stix's alma mater and Joe's alma mater and Wilton's alma mater, mm-hmm. Right. And so we're going to be back at Phyllis Wheatley High School to do a presentation called Who Are the Crusaders for the students at Phyllis Wheatley High School. And so we're really looking forward to that.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Garner. And thank you so much, Stix Hooper, for stopping by. Again, y'all check out the event that's happening tomorrow at Wheatley. And again, thank you for stopping by the Houston, CW39 Houston Digital Dive.
Great.